Good morning students. Today we are going to learn about chemical reactions and equations. Chemical reactions and equations. In this chapter we have to learn about chemical reactions, chemical equations, rules of writing the chemical reactions, balancing a chemical reaction, and types of chemical reactions. Also you have to study about the rate of chemical reactions and about corrosion and rancidity. So before this, we already learned that how the elements are become stable. Elements who are do not have a octet in their outermost orbit, they are trying to become a stable by completing their octet in outer shell. For this purpose, the atoms attempt to complete octet by giving or taking or sharing of electrons. And some atoms are losing their electrons and become stable by complete octet, or some atoms of the elements are accepting the electrons for completion of their octet to become a stable. So in this case, these atoms of the elements comes together for sharing the electron in each of them, and in this case there is a formation of bond, chemical bond, either it may be ionic bond or sometimes it is covalent bond, but in this case there is a formation of compound. In earlier standard, we have seen how the compounds are formed by chemical combination of the elements. So now, in this lesson, we have to study the further concept. That is, what is chemical reaction and related concept. What is chemical reaction? A chemical reaction is a process. Chemical reaction is a process in which some substances undergo bond breaking. Some substances undergo bond breaking and transform into new substance by formation of new bond. A chemical reaction is a process in which some substances undergo bond breaking and are transformed into new substances by formation of new bond. So this is a chemical reaction. In this, some are reactants and some are products. What is reactant? A substance taking part in chemical reaction are called reactant. A substance which are taking part in that chemical reactions are called reactant. And the newly formed substances, a substances formed as a result of chemical reaction by formation of new bonds are called products. Then what is chemical equation? A chemical equation is a representation of that chemical reaction. Chemical equation is a representation of that chemical reaction, and it is written by using different compounds formulae or elements symbol. The representation of chemical reaction in a condensed form using chemical formulae or symbol is called as a chemical equation. So, in this chemical equations, some steps should be followed. What of them? Balancing the chemical reaction. This is the some steps are there in balancing the chemical reaction. Before that, in writing chemical equations, some rules should be followed. What of them? First, that reactant should be, suppose this is a chemical reaction, Na plus Cl equal to NaCl. In this case, these are the reactant and these are the, this is the product. Means, if you want to write the chemical reactions, or chemical equations, this is a chemical equation. It is written by using a formula or symbols that is in condensed form, shortcut. We are writing in shortcut that chemical equation. Word chemical equations we are using, we are writing by using a condensed form. That is known as chemical equation. In this chemical equations, these are the reactants. They are taking parts in this chemical reaction. And this is the newly formed product by bonding in these two elements or two reactants. So, in this case, these are the reactants, these are the products. Reactants we are writing at left side and products should be write at right side. Reactants should be write at left side and products are written at right side. This arrow towards, headed towards product. There's an arrow between product and reactants which is headed towards product. Suppose there are two or more reactant or products, we have to write plus sign like this. In some cases, we are writing here a triangle. That means we are providing heat for that chemical reaction. Sometimes we are writing here some conditions, the temperature of the that reaction or any other instructions are there, or some special conditions are there. Those conditions we are writing here above the arrow or below the arrow. Below the arrow. We are writing their stages also. Different states of the this reactant and product. Some reactants or products in gaseous state, some are in solid state or some are in liquid state. Those states we have to write here. Before that, reactant or product. For gas, we are using Z in bracket. For liquid, L and for solid, S. Some solutions some products or reactants are in the form of solution. Those are written as a aqueous, AQ. In case of products or these reactants are in gaseous state, also we are writing like this, upward arrow. Or if there is precipitates are there, you have to write downward arrow. Then we are also balancing it. This chemical equation should be balanced after this writing. There are some steps should be followed to balance the chemical reaction. In this, first you have to first write the chemical equation from the given word equation. In first step, you have to write the chemical equation from the given word equation. In next step, you have to check whether the equation is balanced or not by comparing the items which are present, atoms of the elements present in both sides of the equation. In next step, it is convenient to start balancing an equation from the compound which contains the maximum number of atoms. Moreover, it is convenient to first consider that element in this compound which has unequal number of atoms on the two sides. First, when we are balancing the equation, at that time it is better to prefer the compound which contains maximum number of atoms, and we have to see on both sides whether the atoms in that compounds are balanced or unbalanced. An unequal number of atoms you have to balance first. So this is the third step. And in fourth step, we have to write down the equation, final balance equation. We have to write once again. These are the same steps we should follow in writing the chemical reactions. Then in this chapter, we have to learn about the types of chemical reactions. These are the major concept in this chapter. There is a types of chemical reactions. There are four major types of chemical reactions. That is combination reaction, decomposition reaction, displacement reaction, and double displacement reaction. These are the major four types of chemical reactions. First, we'll learn about combination reaction. What is combination reaction? When two or more reactants combine in a reaction to form a single product. When two or more reactants combine in a reaction to form a single product, it is called combination reaction. Means, this is also an example of combination reaction. These are the two reactants, is the formation of single product. Or another example, we can write like this: Mg plus O2, MgO. This is the another example of combination reaction. Means two or more reactants combine in a reaction to form a single product. This is a combination reaction. Then decomposition reaction. Decomposition. This is the exact opposite of combination reaction. Means in this chemical reaction, a chemical reaction in which two or more products are formed from a single reactor. Two or more products are formed from a single reactor. For example, calcium carbonate. If you take a calcium carbonate, if you heated it, this formation of calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. So here there are two products from a single reactant. This formation of two or more products from a single reactant is known as decomposition reaction. A chemical reaction in which two or more products are formed from a single reactant is called decomposition reaction. Then next type, displacement reaction. What is displacement reaction? Suppose here Fe plus CuSO4. I taken FeCO. This Cu is replaced by Fe and formation of FeSO4. And this Cu is displaced. Means the reaction in which the place of the ion of less reactive element, in a compound is taken by another more reactive element by formation of its own ions is called displacement reaction. Less reactive ion in the compound is replaced by more reactive ion. The less reactive ion in the compound is replaced by another more active ion, and this is the formation of new compound. Here this ion is displaced, change their place, that's why it is displacement reaction. Then double displacement reaction. Suppose here A, B, these are the friends, and C, D, these are the another pair of friends. Here this friend and A plus B minus, C plus D minus, these are two friends. In double displacement, this and the combination of this occurs. A plus D minus plus C plus B minus. New pairs are formed by exchanging the ions. Here also a decomposition, and here also split up, and they exchange the pair. Exchange of ions in two pairs. The reaction in which the ions in the reactants are exchanged. reaction in which ions of the reactants, these are the ions, two ions in this reactant, two ions in this reactant, ions of the reactants are exchanged to form precipitate or new products. This is called double displacement reactions. Then, so these are the four types of reactions: combination reaction, in which two or more reactants comes together to form a single product. Then next, decomposition reaction, in which two or more products are formed from a single reactant. In displacement reaction, less reactive that ion is replaced by more reactive ion. This is the formation of new products, the displacement. And in double displacement, the exchange of ions in the reactant and formation of precipitate or two more newly formed products. That is double displacement reaction. So these are the four major types of chemical reactions. Then about endothermic and exothermic reaction. What is endothermic and exothermic reaction? In endothermic reaction, the heat is absorbed. During endothermic chemical reaction, heat is absorbed. For example, CaCO3, the calcium carbonate, if you heated the calcium carbonate, then there is a formation of calcium oxide and carbon dioxide. And in this case, we should provide a heat. That heat is absorbed by that calcium carbonate, and then there is a formation of carbon dioxide and calcium oxide. Means, if heat is absorbed during the chemical reaction, that chemical reaction is known as endothermic reaction. And what is exothermic reaction? During exothermic reaction, heat is given away. Heat is given away when reactants are transformed into product. If you take on the calcium oxide and water, if you mix them, there is a formation of calcium hydroxide. But in this case, heat is produced. Heat is given away. That is exothermic reaction. So these are the exothermic reaction and endothermic reaction. Then oxidation and reduction. In some reactions, oxygen is mixed with reactant. That is known as oxidation reaction. In oxidation reaction, oxygen is added or hydrogen is removed. The addition of oxygen is known as oxidation. And what is reduction? Addition of hydrogen or removing oxygen, that is known as reduction. In some cases or some reactions, we are observed that there is a combination of reduction and oxidation. Both reactions you can see in a single reaction. Both phenomena that the reduction of oxygen or addition of hydrogen or reduction of hydrogen and addition of oxygen, these both phenomena we can see in a single reactions. That is, if you see the reduction and oxidation, these both process in a single reaction, that reaction is known as redox. Then we will see about a rate of chemical reactions, factors affecting the chemical reactions, speed of the chemical reactions. Those factors are, first, nature of the reactant. This is the first factor that affects the rate of chemical reaction. Which factors we are using as a reactant depend on that the chemical reaction, either it is fast or slow. Then next, size of the reactant. If you taken a powder of that reactant, the chemical reaction is fastest. And if size of the reactants are large, then the speed of the reaction is slow. A rate of the reaction is slow. Then concentration also affects the rate of chemical reaction. High concentrated reactants are there, then there will be a fast reaction. And sometimes there are dilute or low concentrated factors are there in reactant. At that time, reaction becomes slower. Then temperature also affects the rate of chemical reactions. High temperature helps to speed up the chemical reaction. Then a major factor that affects rate of chemical reactions is catalyst. What is catalyst? We have to define it. Catalysts are the substance which has to speed up that chemical reaction. The substance in whose presence the rate of chemical changes, rate of chemical reaction changes without causing any chemical change into it is called catalyst. Means catalyst are the substance, in presence of that substance the rate of chemical reaction changes without causing any chemical change to it. It causes that product, that substance causes or the affects the rate of chemical change, chemical reaction. But itself, the product itself do not get any chemical change. Means without causing any chemical change to it, it helps to increase the speed of the chemical reaction. For example, in decomposition of hydrogen peroxide into water and oxygen, this reaction takes place slowly. But if you added manganese dioxide in that reaction, the speed of the reaction becomes fast. So this catalyst helps to fast that reaction. Then what is corrosion? Corrosion means there is a rusting or affecting metals. For example, due to various components in the atmosphere, oxidation of metals takes place and resulting in damage in that metal. These different factors or different component of the atmosphere damages that metal, and that metal is affected. This process is known as corrosion. For example, iron rust, that is a reddish color layer, is collected on the iron. This is a example of corrosion of iron, and this problem is very serious. That rust is there, this formation of rust is there on the surface of the that iron metal. We should remember the formula of that rust, Fe2O3XH2O. This is the formula of that rust, a reddish layer which is formed by keeping this iron in open place. So that is the corrosion of iron. Like that, other metals also becomes corrosive due to atmospheric condition. Then next, rancidity. When we use old or leftover cooking oil for making food stuff, it is found to have a foul odor. It is called rancidity. If we use old oil for cooking the foodstuff, that foodstuff becomes a odor, and that odor is foul odor, that is rancidity. If food cooked in such oil, if you taste, that taste is also changes. When we keep that oil or ghee aside for long time, or fried food left aside for long time, then it undergoes air oxidation and becomes rancid. Rancidity in the foodstuff cooked in oil or ghee is prevented by using antioxidant. If you want to prevent this rancidity, we have to use, we can use the antioxidants. The process of oxidation reaction of foodstuff can also be slowed. We can slow down that process by storing it in airtight container. So like this, we can prevent the rancidity by keeping that product in airtight container, or by using that antioxidant. So these are the different concepts we have to learn in this chapter. Dear students, after this video, you read the that chapter which is in textbook and solve the exercise. And if you any doubts, you call me on phone or chat on WhatsApp and other social media. Thank you.